Hi friends, this is Andy from Tech Store, and in this video I'm going to be showing you the latest Lenovo Yoga 520 series of laptops. These are 14 inches 0 to 360 convertible laptops with touchscreen, and we have a Core i3 variant hands-on with us. This is a black variant that we are showing you, and all the other Core i5 and Core i7 variants will look the same. So let's start things. First thing first, it does not come with a user replaceable battery. This is the 45 watt adapter that Lenovo gives along. It's the power rating 20 volts and 2.25 ampere, and so the standard L-pin connector actually. So for a Core i5 with graphic, it will be a 65 watt adapter, and it comes along with a stylus. This is the stylus that Lenovo gives along. Nice little notch for putting it beside. This is the way it looks on the top panel. As you can see, black, jet black, Yoga is mentioned over here instead of the Lenovo logo. That's something surprising. Yoga as brand. It's got the smooth finish, and we have these metal hinges, jet black in color. The entire top panel is with metal hinges, sharp edges both sides. This is the way it looks on the top from far off. As you can see, very standard Yoga finishing. So this is the way the hinges are. As you can see, it is 0 to 360 degrees, very very slim, absolutely slim. It goes behind like this for the convertible mode. Also, so this is the way it looks once opened up. As you can see, pretty much upright, and the screen looks very black. It does not have an anti-glare screen. It has got a full HD glare screen. It will reflect the surroundings, but looks very very premium, to be precise. So this is the way it looks once you have it up close. It's got this grayish finish, metallic grayish finish over here. It's got a chiclet keyboard. It's not a full size chiclet keyboard. It does not have numpad, but it has backlit, so that's a good thing to have. It's got a very good size given for the touchpad, unipad to be precise. It's got a fingerprint scanner. All the Yoga 520s have a fingerprint scanner for enhanced security. They all come with variants of 7th generation processors. You can tuck in the stylus like this on one of the USB ports. That is the reason the stand is given. The audio is by Harman Kardon. You will see. Now this is the way it looks on the left side. It's got this black and grey combination. This is entirely metallic. Charging pin connector, charging pin indicator, HDMI, you have a USB 3.0 C-type connector, you have a headphone mic combi, again, absolutely nothing else apart from that. And we no indicators whatsoever in the front. So on the right, don't have a DVD writer as well, because these are 14 inches slim laptops. You have the power button over here. And you have a reset button, you have the memory card reader, you have a USB 2.0 with which can be used even if the laptop is powered off with the Kensington lock. This is the design element. You have a huge dissipation vent area, which is clear from the rear, so the heat can get dissipated. I don't know why IP520 cannot be designed this way, why it has to block. Just to get blocked by the screen actually. If I can just show you what will make sense once the screen is opened. Even then you have the entire dissipation vent area having clear space for blowing the heat away. So it's a good thing, huge space given here for the heat dissipation on the rear. This is the way the base is. You can see more dissipation vent given here, as well as huge rudder. And pretty much clear design. speaker is over here as well as over here. Two more studs given. So pretty much neat and clean design, grayish finish given. On the contrary, the top is black, as you can see, and the base is entirely having a gray metallic finish. So it's having a IPS panel, as you can see, and the viewing angles are very, very good. As you can see over here, viewing angles are pretty great. Absolutely no ghost images whatsoever from any angle that you would see. Then over here, very bright screen to be precise. So this is where the backlit keyboard is. Bright enough actually. It has got variations in the light, the off, state 1, state 2 brighter, and again power off. So 1, 2, 3 is power off. So bright enough. No gray spots really. Very much visible in the dark. Now this is the way the camera is. Actually the camera is very good. Even the audio capture is pretty neat because of the array microphone that Lenovo has integrated. So 4 out of 5 for this particular camera. Although when you're recording, you might feel there is some jerk or there's some wavy effects, but it is not there once you record the video. So what a good camera by Lenovo in the Yoga 5. Now let me showcase the audio quality for you. The audio quality is very good. Provided by the Harman Kardon speaker system, and here we go. Pretty crystal clear, not very loud, but absolutely thumping. Not tinny to be precise, it is somewhere between very thumpy and less tinny actually. So all in all, it is a very good speaker system that Lenovo has integrated in the Yoga 520. So this, my friends, was a review showing you the Lenovo Yoga 520. You should know that these are 14 inches variant convertible, 0 to 360 degree, full HD IPS with touchscreen, and it comes along with a stylus. And all of these have 7th generation Core i3, Core i5 and Core i7 variant process. So the price range is somewhere around 52,000 rupees for a Core i3 variant without graphic card here in India, up to upwards of 75 to 80,000 rupees for a Core i5 with graphic card variant. This particular model has a backlit keyboard, it has got C-type connector, it has got inbuilt battery, which is a 2-cell lithium-ion battery. It will give you a battery backup somewhere around 4 to 5 hours all in all. And the stylus is a real help with this particular convertible. This model is available on our website techstore.co.in. Thanks a lot for watching, guys. Do let us know your suggestions and comments, and do not forget to subscribe to us. Thank you so much.